Today's anatomy lab is on spleen and lymphatic drainage of the abdomen, pelvis and the lower leg. So before going to this, what is lymph? What is lymph? Which fluid?
Tissue fluid.
Lymph is nothing but tissue fluid. So why it is required? This system? Filtration of the fluid, isn't it? So it is a alternate or accessory to the venous system. Okay. So arterial system, it is having oxygenated blood and it is a it provides the nutrition to the cells, isn't it? So after that, what is venous system? The same blood. What are the impurities are there, and the deoxygenated blood carries through the venous system. Apart from this, at the arterial and capillary bed, and where the venous system begins, at that point where the arterial ends, arterial system ends, there the tissue fluid comes from the arterial system, at that point. So same tissue fluid, it is taken by the lymphatic channel or lymphatic vessel, in lymphatic vessel, where the tissue fluid get filtered in the lymph node, lymph node, it filtrates. So the what is the content of lymph?
This is immune cells, microorganisms,
foreign bodies, microorganisms like cancer cells, and dust, cancer cell, and the protein, macromolecule, bigger molecules are present in the lymph, isn't it? This is about the lymph and lymphatic system. So the what are the lymphoid organs present in the body?
Spleen,
thymus,
tonsils.
Yes, tonsils.
Lymph nodes.
Yeah. And yes, bone marrow also a little bit bigger because it produces stem cells of lymphocytes. Stem cells for lymphocytes, bone marrow. Apart from this, Peyer's patches in the intestine. Peyer's patches. All of the lymphoid organ or lymphoid tissue present in the body, isn't it? So in the today we'll discuss about spleen and the lymphatic drainage of the abdomen, pelvis and the lower limb. So spleen is a lymphoid organ. How you will always you should know these regions while studying in the abdominal organ. So you will get an idea where it is situated. So what is this line? This is midclavicular line. What is this? Transpyloric plane. And intertubercular plane. So this region is epigastric region, left hypochondric and right hypochondric, right lumbar region, left lumbar region, umbilical region, left iliac, right iliac and hypogastric region. So here is a spleen, where it is situated?
Left hypochondrium
and partly in the epigastric region, hypochondric region. About the location of the spleen, is it clear?
Yes.
about the introduction of spleen. Spleen is soft, highly vascular, dark purple in color. It is highly vascular, soft and dark purple in color. And about the location, just now we discussed. It is situated in the left hypochondrium and partly in the epigastrium. Okay. And what is the shape of spleen? Which shaped organ?
Okay.
Which shaped organ related to the 9th to 11th rib? Related to 9th to 11th rib. In between this region, it is located. So, just you memorize the odd numbers from 1. Okay, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 and 11. So, 1 inch thick, 3 inch broad, 5 inch long, 7 ounce in weight, that approximately 200 grams. Okay, 7 ounce and 9th to 11th rib, which is situated. Okay. So, it is a structure of spleen. Okay. Visceral surface and the diaphragmatic surface. About the features of spleen, it is having two ends, anterior end and the posterior end. So this is a spleen. It is like this anatomical position. Okay, in the left hypochondrium. Okay. So it is having two ends, anterior end and the posterior end. Anterior end and the posterior end. Okay. Anterior end and the posterior end. Anterior end expanded, directed downwards and forwards. Directed downwards and the forwards. Posterior end, it is rounded. Okay. Posterior end is how it is rounded. Okay. Directed upwards, backwards and medially. Directed upwards here, posterior end, upwards, okay, and backwards and medially. Okay. This is about the posterior end and the anterior end. So about the borders, it is having three borders. Okay. Superior border, it is the anatomical position of spleen. Superior border, inferior border, and here intermediate border. These are the three borders. It is the anatomical position. Anatomical position. Okay. Superior border, inferior border, here intermediate border.
And it's the superior border and the picture.
So here superior border, inferior border and the intermediate border. Some author will say anterior border, posterior border and the intermediate border. Some author say superior border, inferior border and the intermediate border. Is it clear?
Yes.
And it is the hilum of spleen.
Where?
Splenic artery. Hilum. Next is about the surfaces. It is having two surfaces, the visceral surface and the diaphragmatic surface. So it is the diaphragmatic surface. How it is smooth and convex. How it is? It is smooth. Okay. Smooth and convex. Diaphragmatic surface and the visceral surface. Here one surface is there, isn't it? Outer one is diaphragmatic. Inner one is visceral.
Okay.
Visceral is concave. It is cup shape, isn't it? Concave. And irregular. It is irregular. It is smooth and it is irregular. And wears many impressions. See here, these are the impressions. Okay. Diaphragmatic surface and the visceral surface. This is a spleen and tail of pancreas. About the visceral surface, it bears a gastric impression, colic impression, and the renal impression. Okay. So here it is the gastric impression, colic impression, and the renal impression. So left kidney, it is related with the this impression.
Renal.
Yes. Renal impression. So gastric impression means
stomach
is related to the this impression. Okay. And here colic, large intestine.
Yes.
Splenic flexure, it is related to the this impression. Okay. These are the three impressions. So in the auscultation exam we may ask, identify the organ.
Spleen.
Okay. And the impression. Write about its impressions. So you have to write gastric impression, colic impression, and the renal impression.
Does
like that.
Okay. Does it have lots of blood?
It is having. So example I am giving. We may ask about the impression. Okay. This is about visceral surface of the spleen. Is it clear? So here is a colic impression, hilum. In between the hilum and the colic impression, here the tail of pancreas located or related. So this is pancreatic impression here, just above the colic impression. Here is a colic impression, hilum of kidney, in between these two.
That's
okay, there is a, here is a colic impression, hilum of kidney, in between these two, there is a tail of pancreas, pancreatic impression.
Okay.
Yes, here is a pancreatic surface. This is a hilum of spleen. Hilum of spleen, pancreatic surface, colic surface or impression, or renal surface or renal impression, and the gastric surface, gastric impression. Same thing, isn't it? Gastric, renal, colic, and the pancreatic. And it is a hilum. Next is about the hilum. The inferomedial part of the gastric impression. Inferomedial part of the gastric impression. Just inferior to the gastric impression. It is located and it transmits splenic artery and splenic vein and the nerves. Okay. Splenic vessels and nerve. Okay. We may ask about the hilum also in the auscultation exam. Okay. Identify the organ. What are the structures passing through the hilum? You supposed to write, identify the organ, spleen. Okay. What are the structures passing through the hilum?
Splenic
vessels. Okay, or splenic artery, splenic vein, and the
splenic
nerves. Okay, these are the
blood supply splenic artery.
Yeah, that's what I am telling about. The what are the structures passing through the hilum of spleen? So this is a hilum where, or it is a like a door. So think this room as a spleen, that door is hilum. Same thing here. Okay, so what are the structures passing through the hilum? These are the splenic vessels and nerve. Is it clear?
Yes.
And apart from this, hilum provides the attachment to the gastrosplenic and linorenal ligament. Gastrosplenic ligament and the linorenal ligament. So it is a just a fibrous band attached from gastrosplenic means from stomach to spleen. It is attached at the hilum. And linorenal ligament. Lino means same thing. Renal means kidney. Kidney to the spleen. Linorenal. Okay, from the kidney one attachment is there, and from the stomach one attachment is there. That is ligament. Okay, these two are the ligaments attached to the hilum of spleen. Is it clear?
Yes.
Next is about the arterial supply of spleen. It is supplied by the splenic artery. Give a tortuous arteries in the body.
What?
Tortuous means?
Yes. Not straight.
Not straight, yes. Like this.
Spiral.
Splenic artery, isn't it? It is tortuous. And one more? In the body, I am telling. Facial artery? It is also tortuous. Isn't it? One more? Uterine artery, it is also tortuous. Okay. Out of interest, I am asking these questions.
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay. Tortuous arteries in the body. Facial artery, splenic artery, uterine artery. Okay. Some other artery. Okay.
One of them is.
So it is a.
One of them is.
Splenic artery.
Yes.
Okay. Why it is so?
What?
Why there is a necessary of tortuosity?
Because it's long.
Slow down the blood.
The vessel is long, not enough space.
Yeah. Good for today, maybe. Let's forget.
So much more blood there.
So here
more
blood. During two.
It's a movement.
There is a movement. So because of tortuosity, it may expand or it may. Expand or decrease in the size. Okay. So same thing in the splenic artery, in the abdominal movement, it may move, isn't it? Mm-hmm. So that is why tortuosity is necessary. Same case in this in case of uterine artery also. There is a movement. Wherever the movement is there, there is a tortuous arteries. About the venous drainage of spleen, it is by the splenic vein. Venous drainage, it is by the splenic vein. And next is about the nerve supply. It is by the ciliar plexus. Okay, ciliar plexus. Next is about the functions of spleen. So, functions of spleen, phagocytosis,
yes.
Okay, and hemopoiesis, and immune responses, and the storage of RBC. These are the functions of spleen. Ask a question, maybe, like what are the functions of, identify the organ, and write its function. Huh? What are those functions? Phagocytosis, hemobiosis,
immune response,
responses, and storage of the
RBC.
These are the functions of spleen. Okay. This is about spleen. Is it clear?
Yes.
About spleen?
Yes.
Next is lymphatic drainage of the lower limb. Lymphatic drainage of the lower limb. The superficial inguinal lymph nodes, the arrangement is like T. Okay. These group of lymph nodes are arranged in the T, that is superficial inguinal nerve horizontal group just below the inguinal ligament, and the vertical group here, vertical group arranged vertically along the great siphonous vein. So here is a great siphonous vein. The vertical group is arranged along with the great siphonous vein. Okay. And drainage area, these superficial, from the superficial tissues, that is everything superficial to the deep fascia, okay, superficial tissues drains into the these nodes, and lower limb including the buttocks except posterolateral part of the calf, which is drained by popliteal group of lymph node. Here the popliteal fossa, backside of the knee, popliteal fossa is there. So in this fossa there are lymph nodes, popliteal group of lymph node. Okay. And the lower abdominal wall below the umbilicus, below the, here is the umbilicus, below the umbilicus the lymph is drained by the superficial group of lymph nodes here, TGF, vertical and the horizontal group of lymph nodes. And external genitalia excluding the testes and perineum, lower part of the anal canal and the vagina, and cornu of the uterus by means of lymphatics that follow the round ligament. So these are the areas where the lymph drains into the superficial group of lymph node. Superficial group of lymph node here, located here. Okay, just below the inguinal ligament, there is a horizontal group, and along with the great siphonous vein, the vertical group is there. So all the lymph drains into the superficial group of lymph node. Okay. The next is deep inguinal group of lymph node. Three or four nodes lie medial to the femoral vein on being in the femoral canal. Here is a femoral canal. Femoral canal, deep inguinal group of lymph nodes located here. Okay. And the drainage area of deep inguinal group of lymph node, that is from the gland spinis, okay, and efferent lymphatic from the superficial inguinal nodes that process through the prebrium from fascia, efferent vessels from the deep inguinal nodes passes through the femoral canal to enter the external iliac group of lymph nodes. So it is the thigh, okay, thigh, superficial group of lymph nodes, okay, area of drainage already,
yes,
I taught in previous slide. Okay, so all the lymph collected from the superficial group of lymph node are drained into the deep inguinal group of lymph node, and from deep inguinal group of lymph node it is drained into the external iliac lymph node. Is it clear?
Yes.
External group of lymph node. Yeah, yeah. Superficial. Superficial to deep. And deep to the external group of lymph node. External iliac lymph node. Is it clear? Next is connections with the abdomen. Here is a thorax and the abdomen part. Thorax and the abdomen part. How it is related to the thorax? So, in the breast cancer, here is a manubrium. Manubrium. Okay. Inlet of thorax. Inlet of thorax. Manubrium. And the posterior wall of the thorax and the diaphragm. Okay. Yeah, mid sagittal section through the.
Where is the rib sphincter?
Just it is the anterior wall. Anterior wall.
This is just one part.
Yeah, yeah. Mid sagittal section through the thorax. Just for your understanding, I am telling how it related with the thorax and the abdomen. How this cancer spreads, especially in the breast cancer.
Yes.
Okay. Breast cancer. The lower part of the anterior thoracic wall has a lymphatic connection with the upper part of the anterior abdominal wall. So it is a anterior wall of the thorax. It is having connection with the anterior group of lymph nodes are present. So it is having connection with the lymph nodes which are presented in the abdomen. So the cancer cell, especially in the breast cancer, spread, direct spread from the thorax to the abdomen. Okay. And the cancer of the breast can spread along these connections to abdominal cavity. The upper surface of the diaphragm has lymphatic connection with its lower surface. These vessels provide another channel for the spread of cancer from the thorax to the abdomen. Here, from this group of lymph node present in the thorax may spread into the abdomen. Okay. Lymph node groups in the abdomen. It is the inferior vena cava. Okay, and it is the aorta. Here is the ciliary trunk, superior mesenteric artery, and the inferior mesenteric artery. Wherever arteries are there are lymph nodes, isn't it? Okay, ciliary group of lymph nodes, and superior mesenteric group of lymph nodes, and the inferior mesenteric group of lymph nodes. So these are the, this group will call pre-aortic group of lymph nodes. Pre-aortic or ventral to the aorta. So here is a aorta. The ventral branches, how many are there? They are in three numbers: ciliary trunk, superior mesenteric, and the inferior mesenteric at the ventral side of the aorta. Three branches. Okay. On lateral side, on either side of the aorta. Okay. Side of a aorta. There are branches are there, lumbar branches, okay, and renal artery. These are the lateral branches from the aorta. Is it clear? So pre-aortic related to the three ventral branches of the aorta: ciliary group, superior mesenteric, and the inferior mesenteric group of lymph node. And para-aortic related to the lateral branches of the aorta. Is it clear?
Yes.
Para aortic group of lymph node, pre-aortic group of lymph nodes. Para means on either side of the aorta. Celiac nodes around the stem of the celiac trunk. Stomach, spleen. Okay, here is a celiac trunk. So here the lymph nodes are there around the celiac trunk. celiac group of lymph nodes. Okay, around the celiac trunk, the lymph nodes are there. So, these lymph nodes drained by left gastric, splenic, hepatic groups in addition to the pyloric and right gastroepiploic group of related to the gastroduodenal branch of the hepatic artery. So, gastroepiploic group of lymph nodes here, okay, in the greater curvature of the stomach, okay, and pyloric group of lymph nodes here at the pylorus end of the stomach, okay, and the left gastric group of lymph node here at the lesser curvature of the stomach, okay, and all these group of lymph nodes from the lymph from all these group of lymph nodes is ultimately drains into the celiac group of lymph node, which is the major channel. So all these are minor channels, all are drains into the celiac group of lymph node. Okay, this is about the celiac nodes. The superior and inferior mesenteric lymph nodes, pre-aortic lymph nodes. So here the inferior mesenteric artery, okay, around this there are lymph nodes, and these are the mesocolic lymph nodes, okay, and epicolic group of lymph nodes, and paracolic. Para means side of the large intestine. Lymph nodes are there. Okay, all are ultimately drains into the inferior mesenteric and the superior mesenteric group of lymph node. So arterial supply of gut, hind gut, foregut, midgut, and hindgut. Gastrointestinal tract, it is divided into foregut, midgut, and the hindgut, isn't it? From the mouth to the up to where? Second part of the duodenum. Okay, at the major duodenal papillae. Till there, that is foregut. Artery of foregut is celiac artery. Celiac trunk, ventral branch. Okay. Artery of midgut, superior mesenteric artery. From second part of duodenum to the large intestine, right 1/3 of the transverse colon of large intestine. So here is a large intestine, right 1/3 up to here. From the duodenum up to here, it is the midgut. It is supplied by the superior mesenteric artery. Okay, left 1/3 of transverse colon up to the anus, sigmoid colon and the anus, it is hindgut.
Inferior mesenteric.
Is it clear? Arterial supply of gut. Whole GIT, it is divided into three parts.
Yes.
Foregut, midgut, and hindgut. Artery of foregut, celiac artery. Okay. Artery of midgut, superior mesenteric artery. Artery of hindgut, inferior mesenteric artery. So, in this respect, the inferior, the group of lymph node, inferior mesenteric group of lymph nodes are drained. Okay, in this respect only. And superior mesenteric group of lymph node drain lymph from all the parts in the midgut. Okay, and ultimately drains into the cisterna chyli. Cisterna chyli. Ultimately, all these drains to the cisterna chyli. So, lymph from the intestinal part, that is turbid. Always we will say, how is, what is the color of lymph?
No. White.
It is white.
White gray.
It is white, we will tell. Whereas in case of lymph from the intestine. Lymph from the intestine, it is turbid. Rest of the part, it is clear or colorless. Is it clear? Why it is turbid? Due to presence of the fat. So it is absorption from the intestine. So it contains fat lobules, isn't it? That is why it looks turbid. Intestinal part of the lymph. Okay, it is turbid.
So is this important? Is it important?
That is important only.
Lymphatic system. So it is easy. Just you make a skeleton. Okay, para-aortic group, pre-aortic and the para-aortic group of lymph nodes. Okay, pre-aortic means celiac, superior mesenteric and the inferior mesenteric. Okay, one diagram is there. Next one diagram is there. You will come to know by looking at that diagram. So this is about the para-aortic group of lymph nodes. Drain iliac nodes which receives from the pelvis and the lower limb. Para-aortic group of lymph nodes. The lymph drains from the pelvis and the lower limb. Whatever lymph is collected from the lower limb and the pelvis are drains into the para-aortic group of lymph node. Okay. On either side of the aorta. See here, plan of lymphatic drainage in the abdomen. So this is a aorta. On either side, para-aortic group of lymph nodes are there. Okay. And these are the pre-aortic group of lymph nodes. Celiac, superior mesenteric and the inferior mesenteric. So in the celiac group of lymph node, lymph drains from the area, stomach, liver, spleen and the pancreas. In these areas, lymph drains into the celiac group of lymph nodes. Okay. In the superior mesenteric and the inferior mesenteric group of lymph nodes, drains the intestinal lymph. Okay. And from the lower limb and the pelvis, the whatever the lymph is drained in from the pelvis part, these are drains into the internal iliac group of lymph node.
Superficial.
Okay. And whatever the lymph drains from the lower limb, drains into the external iliac group of lymph nodes.
Yes.
And ultimately drains into the common iliac group of lymph node. And this common iliac group of lymph nodes drains into the para-aortic. Okay, apart from this para-aortic group of lymph nodes, these lymph nodes, the lymph drains from the suprarenal, kidney and the gonads. Okay, and these ultimately drains into the cisterna chyle.
What is cisterna chyle?
Cisterna?
The diagram for cisterna chyle.
Yeah, it is a lymph vessel, largest lymph vessel. That is, it continues as a thoracic duct. It is a sac like a structure at the L1.
Lumbar
one? Yeah. Okay. On right side of the lumbar vertebra, it is like a shack, cisterna chyle. It is like a shack. So all the lymph drains into the cisterna chyle. Okay. From cisterna chyle, one tube is there that we call the thoracic duct. Okay. Ultimately, that drains into the superior vena cava. Whatever. After the filtration of the lymph, ultimately drains into the venous system. Okay, is it clear? So this is a plan of lymphatic drainage of the abdomen.
So read this only. Read only this.
This one?
Yes.
You will come to know, you will have an idea, isn't it?
Yes.
By looking at this diagram. Huh? Okay. This is about lymphatic drainage of the pelvis. Here, the internal iliac lymph node, okay, and the external iliac lymph node. External iliac artery and the internal iliac artery. It is the mid sagittal section through the pelvis. Okay. So external iliac and internal iliac artery. Here are the lymph node. External and internal group of lymph node and lymph nodes in facial sheath. Here also the lymph nodes are there. Okay. And apart from this, the sacral arteries are there, isn't it? So on either side of the sacral arteries, there also you can see the sacral group of lymph node. See here, sacral group of lymph nodes here, okay. Median sacral group and the lateral sacral group here, and these are the external iliac. Here is a common iliac, external iliac and the internal iliac. Internal iliac group of lymph nodes and the external iliac group of lymph nodes. Okay, all are drains. So ultimately drains into the external iliac group of lymph node, and from here the para-aortic group of lymph node, ultimately it drains into the cisterna chali. From cisterna chali to thoracic duct and superior vena cava. Okay. Same thing, whatever I explained now, it is there. The external iliac lymph node, internal iliac lymph node and the sacral node. Okay. And the common iliac group of lymph nodes.
Then Baba.
Yes.
After that it goes with Baba follicular, Baba aortic.
Para aortic. Ultimately para aortic to the cisterna chali. It is just sac like structure in the on the side of L1 vertebra. Okay. Just below the right crush of diaphragm. Right crush of diaphragm, just below the right crush of diaphragm, from the side of the L1, that is lumbar first vertebra, is sac like structure or just like a storage. Ultimately all the lymph drains into that, and from that thoracic duct, and ultimately drains into the superior vena. Yes.
The first drains of the pelvis. It drains upward.
Upward.
What about the gastric group?
Gastric
group? Mesenteric.
In the ciliary group of lymph node.
Yes. They drain also upward?
Yeah. That ultimately drains into the cisterna chali.
What about the tonsil?
See here. From the intestine, inferior mesenteric and superior mesenteric drains into this and ultimately drains into the cisterna chali. Okay. See here, all the lymph drains ultimately into the cisterna chali here. All the lymph. Here, your question, stomach, liver, spleen and pancreas.
Intestines.
Drains into the?
About the intestines.
About the intestine.
Upwards also.
Yeah, upwards also. Inferior mesenteric group of lymph nodes collects, superior group of lymph nodes. Lymph collected and directly drains into the cisterna chali. Okay. Yes. Is it clear?
Yes.